What was it for you that like shifted, that made you really realize that like, okay, I gotta take my destiny into my own hands?
Right. So being homeless, I had so many different experiences being homeless, right? So I was pretty popular in high school, but when you're homeless, you're not able to shower like you want to. Like, I was still trying to make it to classes. You know, I went from being the cool kid with the cool kicks, with the fresh cut, to being the smelly guy, the guy without, you know, and you really learn how people change, or the people that truly rock with you. Mm-hmm. Like, I was speaking at St. John's earlier today, and I was like, the people that you think really support you, rock with you, aren't going to be there when times really, really, really hit rock bottom. So it was my first time learning at a very young age. Some of us don't learn this really until adulthood, learn that how fickle people are, mm-hmm. and how, you know, you only have a really small circle of true supporters during the rough times. And then, you know, seeing like the most compassion of someone sharing their food, their last bit of food with you when you're hungry, right? To, I was living outside of like a broken down car, to someone busting the windows in a car. So I kept all of my belongings in this car, and having somebody bust the windows in that car in the middle of winter to steal the stuff, like steal my stuff. That's all I had.
Wow.
You know? And so you go through these highs and these lows where it's like, man, like that was like one of the like most like rock bottom moments, you know, when I was homeless, when someone broke into my car and stole my stuff. And I slept in there, and it was wintertime, right? And so, dude, like I have a broken window that doesn't shield me from the elements, right? But then another time where it's like, hey, I am starving, I am hungry, and somebody else out on the street gives you some McDonald's. Like they got some money to get some McDonald's, they give it to you, right? Like those moments where they don't have to do that, right? This person doesn't have shit either, but they have that much compassion in their heart, right? And so you never truly lose hope. And seeing those moments where people are so compassionate, like I used to wash windows at the gas station or ask people to shovel their snow or whatever I could to like make money. And you know, those days where you do that and someone gives you $20 to wash your windows. And that is just like, bro, this is dope, right? You know what I mean? Like I can do this, I can take this, or you made enough money where you can stay in a motel for a night and you're staying in like a motel that's $39 a night, but you're in a bed and you're so grateful and you're like, there's only 15 TV channels in here and it smells like cigarettes, but man, like I am so grateful.
And you're safe.
I'm safe in that moment. And those moments is what kept me going. Those moments and those acts of human decency made me continue to believe like these things are happening for a reason. These things are happening to keep my spirits uplifted.